Well, Lewis just texted. Burgers or meatballs for dinner? I'll text back for you. Same thing, bitch. Just different shapes.
You are ruining my chances of getting a puppy!
That is correct, shorty.
Flashing my girlfriend during her business call. All embarrassed.
Going to be showing you my boobies tonight.
I see your boobie.
We're going to go to bed without the boobies.
Yeah.
You get that?
No. Boobie.
Straight girls are always on some men fucking suck. I'm going to go gay now. Honey! If you think getting your heart broken by a man fucking sucks, the first time you get your heart broke by a woman, you will actually want to kill yourself.
Listen, y'all dominant femmes are something else. I'm a freak, but I won't be telling y'all to slut me out like that. I was messing with this one femme. Hey, she was with the shit. Listen, we was kissing. Shawty picked me up. I ain't never been picked up before.
But I liked it.
Then she threw me on the bed. I'm talking about pick me up and threw me like it was a damn wrestling mat. He said, open your legs. I was like, open my legs?
Okay, daddy.
Hey, she was rough, but I ain't gonna cap. I do like that rough shit. Just a little bit. And she was going to work. Yo, listen. Where the Dom Femmes at? Because I need a Dom Femme. Where the Dom Femmes at? Because look. Come put it on me.
People be like, oh, you're just gay for attention. No. I look hot for attention. I am gay because I like to eat pussy.
Hey, TikTok, it's us, your favorite lesbians. Probably not. Bae has this look on her face because we're arguing. And I don't mean like a cute hee hee ha ha argument. I mean like a real married folks argument. This is the moral of this TikTok. We are arguing, like not speaking to one another, arguing. We had to run errands today together. Haven't spoken to one another the entire time. We ain't got nothing to say to one another. I get out of the car to run my errand. I get back in the car and Bae puts a pause on the argument to share some tea because this is how petty we are. We have to put a pause on the argument so that she can tell me what she's found.
So you can be abreast.
Via the internet while I was in the store.
Because most people say thank you.
And then after.
Now I want to talk to you. You can get them out of here too. I don't want to talk to y'all either.
We're back to where we.
I hate when guys find out I'm bisexual and they're like, oh, you want to have a threesome? Yes. Yes, I do. I want to have a threesome, a fivesome, a sixsome. I want titties around and inside my mouth, but it's not because I'm bisexual. It's because I'm a whore.
Things I wish I knew about dating girls before I started dating girls. Part 7. I just hope you know one of y'all gotta kill the Spider-Man, and it's not gonna be her, so you better put your big old pants on and act tough, because it's on you. It's on you.
Every La Dollar Bean couple has a scary bottom or switch and a clueless top.
Thank you. So my girlfriend and I just got off FaceTime, and usually when we're about to get off the phone, I show her a little cherry or two, you know, just to spice things up in our relationship. And this time I couldn't because I'm in the parking lot of my job. And the look on her face, it was as if she was mourning the death of my tatas. As if I don't show her around the fucking clock every goddamn day my teeters. Now, she is not the victim here. I'm not going to feel bad. I'm going to sit here and continue on my life, because at the end of the fucking day, you'll get some. But with that attitude, nah. Stop it. Stop it right now. You're fine.
Okay, so let's say that you want to read a sapphic book. And before I get into this, I know that there are so many wonderful WLW books, but these are just my top recs. I'm going to go fast to try to keep up. Let's start in young adult contemporary. Tell Me How You Really Feel, The Henna Wars, You Should See Me in a Crown, Everything Leads to You, and Her Royal Highness. Now to young adult science fiction fantasy, Girls, Serpent, Thorn, Cinderella is Dead, Crier's War, Of Fire and Stars, and Girls of Paper and Fire. Now let's do some science fiction fantasy. I haven't actually read these yet, they're just on my list. Gideon the Ninth, The Priory of the Orange Tree, and Plain Bad Heroines. Now to my favorite, New Adult Romance, Written in the Stars, Honey Girl, and Something to Talk About. Oh, and we can't forget The Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo. Now still to come out in 2021 would be She Who Became the Sun, Not My Problem, Satisfaction Guaranteed, Love and Other Natural Disasters, and I can't end this with Red, White, and Royal Blue, so instead we'll end it with One Last Stop, baby!
Everybody is always like, you don't look gay. But, like, what? Like, do I have to dress like a fucking package of Skittles every day? Do I need to wear rainbows? Like, do I need to dress up as the LGBTQ flag? How do I look gay? Like, please tell me. How the fuck can I look gay?
We interrupt your typical programming to let you fruitcakes know that Simple Gay Apparel is releasing the Fruity Collection, which is available now. Just click the link in the description box below. Now back to the lesbians. Let's go, lesbians.
That's not true. I am not a crybaby.
Oh, so you're gonna deny it, huh? What about when the two of us are alone playing punishment games? Tell us what happens then, Kaoru.
I know it's Mother's Day today, but I will instead be celebrating the fact that I went to the store this morning and the cashier was really cute. And I complimented her nose ring, she complimented my necklace, and then I ran out because gay panic, right? And so I sat in my car for a second until I was like, wait, no. The worst she can say is no, stop being such a baby. So I walked back inside and I was like, excuse me, would it be okay with you if I asked you for your number? And she said, yes. Would you like for me to write it down? And I was like, yeah, you can write it down. My name's Ashlyn, by the way. And she was like, it's really nice to meet you. And I said, it's really nice to meet you too. So I have her number, and happy overcoming gay panic.
I'm talking to a girl again. R.I.P. my mental health. R.I.P. my mental.
Screw them if they can't take a joke! You can dance, you can dance, having the time of your life.
Here's what I think your favorite ship says about you.
You love friends to enemies to lovers / childhood friends to lovers, and you probably have some unresolved mental health issues.
You really like angst. You're emotional and or closeted.
You have zero taste and I do not respect you.
You have a thing for women
of the murderous variety.
You're just, you know, a wholesome person.
You have good taste.
You're individual and strong-willed.
You're a purist and a little bit vanilla.
You're probably bisexual.
You either want a big titty goth GF or you are a big titty goth GF.
You know it's not going to become canon, but you're too invested, so you can't let it go.
You're a little bit toxic.
You're very toxic.
You just want them to be happy, and you have a very good gaydar.
You're in pain.
I'm not afraid anymore. What makes you sure you're alive?
To my future wife, I'm not the girl your mother warns you about. I won't kiss your best friend or break your heart. I won't make you choose between what you love to do and me. I'm not cold, nor am I reckless. I will love you more than anything. I will kiss you when you cry. I will stand by your side until you decide otherwise. Love me.
Take me to places I know.
This video that was talking about how girls flirt with girls, and I recently got back on the market and I found that I was on the phone with someone and I was like, you're so pretty, and she thought that I was just trying to be her friend, so then I had to hit her with them. Yo, you're so pretty, like, we should hang out. And then she got it.
I better watch my 5'2" mouth. First of all, I'm glad you said that. I'm not 5'2", I'm 5'3". I said that on the Cassie song, I was like,
have you seen the state of her body? If I beat it, I ain't wearing a Johnny. Adiola, I wanna roll with a geezer. Is it me or the lifestyle, sweetheart? Actually, I don't give a shit. I'm a rapper now, might as well live in it.
Hey.
Listen, I'm a lesbian, but when Cardi B said broke boys don't deserve no pussy,
I know that's right.
It's a woman's world, so to speak. Pussy you sour, never giving credit where it's due, cause you don't like pussy in power. Venom.